When you're shooting on location, things rarely go to plan. Shoot delays happen, gear malfunctions, and the weather typically doesn't care too much about your shoot. My name is Aiden Robbins, and as a filmmaker focused mainly on capturing the outdoors, I'm pretty used to shooting in rugged locations with minimal budget and planning. So today I want to share with you a few of the techniques that I use to stay organized on a run and gun shoot and roll with the punches when every single thing inevitably goes wrong. Just like any other project, when you're getting ready for a run and gun on location shoot, you want to set yourself up for success before the shoot actually begins. For me, this means packing only the gear that I need for the shoot and nothing more. To give you an example from my own camera bag, I typically only carry my three most used lenses, 14mm, 35mm, and 85mm. Sure, sometimes it would be great to have a 70-200 on hand, but it's a massive lens that I don't use nearly enough to justify the extra weight that it can bring me down on location. For the same reason, I shoot absolutely everything handheld. Of course, on every project, it would be great at some point to have some kind of gimbal or camera stabilizer, but I just can't justify carrying it around and taking the extra time to set it up just to get a few shots. So instead, I keep that out of my camera bag, travel light, and shoot absolutely everything handheld. Regardless of the gear you choose to carry, you need to know it inside and out. Know what every single button and setting on your camera does, and know where everything is in your camera bag. You need to dedicate time to mastering the intricacies of your tools and technique. This way, when it comes time to shoot, you're not fumbling around trying to find a filter or how to change the picture setting on your camera. I promise I will give you some techniques for when you're actually on the ground shooting in a minute, but first we need to talk about the importance of planning. You need to plan as much of your shoot as you possibly can before it actually comes time to hit the location. The biggest waste of time when you're on location is to still be planning the shoot when you should be shooting the shoot. To be in your Airbnb asking whoever you're working with, okay, what do you think we should do tomorrow? Or how do you think we should set up these shots for the next part of the video? It's so important to invest the right amount of time into planning before the shoot so that when you get to that location, you already know exactly where you're going, ideally exactly when you're going to go there, how long you're going to spend at each location, and exactly what you need to do when you get there. Make a detailed schedule, make a route map showing everywhere you need to go, make shot lists, maybe even storyboards. Personally, I'll make a color-coded hour-to-hour schedule of everything we need to do every day of a given shoot. And I'll also make a Google Maps template that has all of the locations saved, as well as maybe some restaurants in the area for when we're between shoots, need to go find some food, where the Airbnb is, marking down all of these locations so that we know exactly where we need to go and how to get there. On the creative side, I also like to make shot lists for sequences that are crucial to the project where missing a shot would have some major consequences. And I also even storyboard a few shots for each project, particularly shots that are gonna be complicated to pull off, but that need to be executed the right way to work. Do what feels like an excessive amount of planning before each shoot, but, and this is the hard part, try and be comfortable knowing that your plan is gonna completely fall apart. For a lot of filmmakers, that's a tough pill to swallow, but it's just the reality of shooting in these environments. I mean, you have no way, no matter how much you plan, of guaranteeing that there's gonna be a good sunset for you to shoot on Thursday, April 16th. You just don't know that. And that's why it's so important to be adaptable to change. For me, this often means being able to get two different sequences out of the same location, and even having two different plans, one in case of different weather conditions taking place. To give you a little case study from one of my own projects, last year I teamed up with Adorama to create a launch ad for the Lumix S5, and this was a two-day, very run-and-gun shoot shot almost entirely in the outdoors. We wanted to tackle a storyline that featured very specific weather conditions, but of course we had no way to plan to have certain weather at a certain time. So instead, we came up with a flexible plan where we had two different sequences we could shoot at any given time. One much darker and stormier, and the other much lighter and sunnier. So depending on the weather conditions we got at a given time and location, we would shoot whatever sequence made sense. This next one is also kind of a tough pill to swallow for a lot of filmmakers, but you need to decide which corners you're willing to cut. Sometimes I don't use an ND filter. I never use lens caps, and I rarely capture any production audio while I'm filming. Sounds pretty heathenous, right? No matter how much you plan and how efficiently you shoot, sometimes in these run and gun situations, it's just not possible to get every single detail right. And that's why you need to really take a step back and think, which corners can I cut to have the minimal impact on the final product? I add almost all of my sound design in post, so even though I'm cutting that corner by not capturing production audio, it doesn't have much of an impact on the final product. But if you're shooting a documentary, not capturing production audio is not a corner that you can cut. Instead, maybe as a documentary filmmaker, you choose to cut a different corner using a lens that isn't as sharp as you would like it to be and doesn't give you the depth of field that you want. But you choose to use that lens because it has a good zoom range, so it makes more sense for a documentary. It saves you time. If you're shooting in an uncontrolled environment, you're going to have to cut a corner or two, so make sure they're the right ones. And finally, if all else fails, be able to fix it in post. For the Lumix S5 shoot we talked about earlier, we had this one sequence on our final day where we really needed to get a nice, colorful sunrise, and it just didn't happen. It was cloudy and very gray. So I faked it in post. I faked it. Of course, never plan to fix it in post, but be able to if you have no other option. I think that's kind of a recurring, overarching theme of this video, to set yourself up for success, but be able to roll with the punches when everything inevitably goes wrong. I want to end this video with a personal story, kind of an anecdote, a fable of sorts, to stress the importance of everything I've talked about in this video. Almost exactly a year ago, myself and my friends over at TMS Productions went to the Pacific Northwest for a week to make this film, and I did all of the steps right. I made a detailed itinerary and a shot list and a map of the locations, and I did all of the things I've talked about in this video to plan this video about the Pacific Northwest. And it's the Pacific Northwest, so I was planning for a ton of rain and fog and gloom and all of that weather that the Pacific Northwest is known for. And then we get to the Pacific Northwest and we're greeted by a week of sun, not a drop of rain for the entire shoot. You can imagine my initial plan for the film had to be revised quite a lot during that week, and that's what we did. We made a video that was less about rain and gloom and more around beautiful sunrises and sunsets, and I even had a sequence where I used a waterfall and sound design to fake a rainstorm. The weather doesn't care, natural light doesn't care about your shoot. You can go to the Pacific Northwest and not get a drop of rain. Anything can happen when you're shooting in these environments. And that's why you need to learn to thrive in the madness. Thrive with these limitations. Teach yourself how to get amazing footage handheld with one lens in terrible lighting conditions. And then when the time comes and everything does line up in your favor, you're gonna be unstoppable. I hope you've enjoyed or learned something new from this video. Of course, make sure to subscribe to Adorama TV for more videos just like this one. You can also subscribe to me. Just throwing it out there, you didn't hear it from me. And next time you go out to shoot and absolutely everything goes wrong, you know what to do.